The latest on the aftermath of Typhoon Egay. The death toll from the storm now at 25, with 52 others injured. Disaster officials say 23 remain missing, including four Coast Guard personnel from a boat that capsized off Cagayan. In all, the storm affected some 2.3 million people across 13 regions. Over 100 places now also under a state of calamity, including the entire Cagayan province. Total cost of damage from the typhoon has climbed to 5.4 billion pesos.
One of the hardest hit areas by Super Typhoon Egay is Bataan. And on Saturday, the province declared a state of calamity due to effects of Egay and continuous rains brought by Tropical Storm Falcon. Let's get an update. We have on the line Mark Rafael Ramos, Chief Operations and Warning Division of the Bataan PDRRMO. Mark, thank you so much for joining us.
Hello po. Good evening po, Ma'am Denise, at sa inyong mga taga-pakinig.
And how is it in Bataan right now?
As of now, dito po sa probinsya ng Bataan, nakakaranas po kami ng light to moderate with occasional heavy rains po dito sa ating lalawigan.
And how much is the estimated cost of damage to infrastructure by Typhoon Egay in Bataan?
In terms naman po sa damage to infrastructure, as of now, we are still conducting assessment po in terms po dito po sa damage sa ating infrastructure. While in the damage in agriculture, we have the partial and unofficial report coming from our Office of the Provincial Agriculturist. As of July 30, 2023, a total amount of 28.2 million has been damaged in our agriculture sector, ma'am.
Mark, are there any casualties in Bataan or missing people?
As of now po, as we speak po, in God's grace po, wala po tayong talang casualty dito po sa probinsya ng Bataan.
Now let's talk about affected families, or how many families were displaced or affected by Super Typhoon Egay.
Yes po, as per monitoring po, as of July 31 po, we have 734 families with 2,663 individuals has been evacuated inside the evacuation center. A total of 42 evacuation center has been opened, which is as of now, 37 has been closed. So ibig sabihin po, yung iba po ay napauwi na rin po mula po sa mga evacuation center nila.
And what's being done to assist, of course, these affected families, of course, who have lost their homes during the typhoon?
Yes po, as of now po, ongoing din po yung coordination with our Provincial Social Welfare and Development Office together with the City and Municipal MSWDO to give some ayuda to the affected families po.
Mark Rafael Ramos, Chief Operations and Warning Division of the Bataan PDRRMO. Mark, thank you so much for joining us and please take care.
Thank you po. Maganda gabi.
The Philippine province of Bulacan reeling from widespread flooding. At least 22 areas are still inundated, caused by heavy rains from Super Typhoon Egay and the southwest monsoon. Bulacan Vice Governor Alex Castro cites several factors that could have contributed to rising flood waters. This includes in construction activities and the overflowing of dams. Over 21,000 individuals, that's 5,600 families, have been displaced due to floods.
Kailangan po talaga balance lang. Balance po na may development but hindi po nasasacrifice yung environment. And then po magkaroon ng maayos na planning para po hindi po naapektuhan yung ating mga kababayan katulad ng ganitong klaseng mga sitwasyon na biglang lakas ng ulan, tuloy-tuloy, nagkaroon po ng malaking pagbaha sa buong lalawigan.
Bulacan Governor Daniel Fernando says the province has so far suffered 93 million pesos in damage to their agriculture because of the recent weather disturbances.